Liberation theology is a theology of the people. It's a byproduct of the struggle of the poor to overcome oppression. It starts with people in their life situation. Its starting point is the experience of oppression, rooted in the life of the poor. Liberation theology flows from the Latin American churches. It's associated with writers such as Gustavo Gutierrez, Leonardo Boff, John Tobrino, and Juan Luis Segundo, just to name a few. If there's a Magna Carta of liberation theology, then surely it's Gutierrez's A Theology of Liberation. Another academic theology. Liberation theology involves ideas in action in both church and society. There are various kinds of liberation theology, and despite differences, these theologians have in common a commitment to do justice and to transform social reality as a fulfillment of the biblical message. The only power that can truly liberate people is God's love, but it needs our human cooperation. This relationship with a God who loves us first and loves us freely universalizes and liberates our love for others. In liberation theology, Jesus Christ is the liberator. God liberates because God is a God of life. Liberation brings life, and liberation brings us into a new communion with God and others, so we too become liberators. God is revealed and God's word is heard among the exiles, the dispossessed, the peoples on the margin of the world. Christ is to be found there. He announces the kingdom of God to the poor. Proclaims life to those who least have it. The cross shows that God has drawn near to this world. He is a God with us and a God for us. It's in the cross that God's love for us appears with maximum clarity. God's kingdom is for all. God has a special tenderness for the poor. It's important to see why does God love the poor. Not because they are good, but because they are poor. Because they live in conditions that God does not want. So liberation theology is about responding to and giving voice to the poor. So what can we do for the poor, for those on the margins of society, the homeless, the AIDS victims, the housebound, the aged, those with dementia, the mentally ill, the unemployed. Those are whose poverty is spiritual. And there are many sources of oppression, racial, sexual, cultural, and even religious, besides economics. Christian concern for the poor has often been very condescending. Handouts. Compassion rather than justice. When we fail to serve the poor and the lowly, we fail to recognise the face of Christ. And if we can't love the sister and the brother whom we have seen, how on earth can we claim to love God whom we haven't seen? Maybe we've turned a blind eye to both. And liberation theology is founded on such questions. The basic question being, how are we to be Christian in the world of the poor and impoverished? To know God is to act in justice and love for our brothers and sisters, and indeed for the whole of creation.